There was a book out a few years back called It's Not the Big That Eat the Small, It's the Fast That Eat the Slow. And that's where lean comes in. You know, I don't know about you, but I grew up in the 50s and we were all dipped in, Henry Ford and the economies of scale and mass production, make lots of the same color Model T kind of a thing. And the trick is, after the war, Toyota was in this position where they couldn't make a lot of things. They needed to make three trucks and four cars and a handful of this and a handful of that. And so to be able to do that, to be that flexible, they had to find ways to do things more quickly, to change over more quickly, to do all of that stuff more quickly. And this led to what I call the economies of speed. Now, a couple of years back, Toyota actually made more profit than Ford, GM, and Chrysler combined. And so I think you might consider that this might be an opportunity here. All right, so rule number one is if you want to accelerate your speed, you're going to need to eliminate all of the delay that's built into your process. All right, processes grow up in sort of an ad hoc fashion, and we time spreads out, and we get all this other stuff in there, and we get, decision loops and approval loops and this and that and the other thing. Well, you want to get rid of all that delay. So in 1990, there was a book called Competing Against Time by Stock and Hout. And at the time, they were talking about how the Toyota production system is something that GM, Ford, and Chrysler ought to really jump on and get going. And they came out with some rules, and I've tweaked them a little bit. But the first rule is called the 357 rule. Now, it's not the Dirty Harry, go ahead and make my day rule. This is the idea that for any hour of elapsed time, employees are only working on the product for 3 minutes out of every hour. The other 57 minutes are delay. Now, what most people say to me is they go, "Jay, what in the heck are you talking about? My people are all busy." Well, yeah, your people are busy, but if you watch your product or your service go through that process, it's sitting around twiddling its thumbs, waiting on something to happen. So if you take your eyes off your people and put your attention on the product or service going through your process, you'll quickly discover it spends a lot of time waiting on something to happen. All right, so that means we've got almost an hour of delay sitting around out there. Now, the other thing about this rule is people go running around trying to find ways to make their employees faster. What? If they're only working on the product or service for 3 minutes out of every hour of elapsed time, even if you make your people twice as fast, it only takes them a minute and a half. Guess what? You're not going to change your total cycle time one iota. All right, so we will have to get rid of the 57 minutes of delay. And the tools we use to do that are the value stream map and spaghetti diagram. Now, this leads us into the next rule, which is the 15 to 20 rule. This means for every 15 minutes per hour, you reduce delay. It'll double productivity and increase profit margins by 20%. Well, if we got almost 60 minutes, right, we could double, quadruple, octuple our productivity. We could increase profit margins by 20, 40, 80, 100%. And you'll find that that actually happens. As you get faster and gets rid of all the delay, all of a sudden you have a lot more time to do a lot more stuff. All right. And your customers will notice and they'll all want more from you. All right. They want more from you. They just don't get it from you now because they know it's going to take too long. All right. So they hesitate to buy, but if they can just drive right in and get right in, get what they want immediately, bingo, off we go. And that leads us to the third rule, which is the 3x2 rule. It says when you do this, you grow 3 times faster than your competitors and you double profit margins. So I don't know about you, but if you'd like to double your profit margins, maybe lean would be the way to go. All right, so these three rules say that you want to eliminate the delay. And one of the first ways to do that is with what's called the 5S process. Okay, and so we'll get into the 5S process next.